In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to animate a flying Superman with Apple Motion 5. Let's see what we need to design to create this Superman character. We'll need two cape layers, the Superman's head group, a neck and a body group, two legs and arms, the right arm comes with a shadow. We also need horizontal speed lines. We'll start with the cape first. To animate the cape, we'll add the wave distortion effect to the first cape. Make sure the wave effect is added to the first cape layer, not the cape group. Then, select vertical wave and change the wavelength value. Adjust the wave's control points so that the wave will not be cut off around the edges. Add a ramp behavior to the wave's offset. To create a perfect loop for the cape, change the ramp's end value until the cape looks exactly the same at the starting and ending point of your project. The cape is moving in the wrong direction. Let's change the end value to a negative value and it'll be moving in the opposite direction. Adjust the first cape group's anchor point and position. Create a copy of the first cape layer, and move this copied layer to the second cape group. Let's change its color to a darker red shade, and we'll have two cape layers. Adjust the control points of both capes so that they don't look exactly the same. Next, we'll add some up and down motion to the Superman by keyframing the Superman group's Y position and Z rotation. Select repeat before the first and last keyframe for the Z rotation to create a perfect loop. After having the main up and down motion for the character, we'll continue with animating the character's body parts. Copy the Z rotation keyframes of the Superman group, and paste them onto the right leg group. Edit keyframes to adjust the right leg's animation speed. And select repeat after last keyframe to loop the right leg's animation. Then, offset the right leg's rotation keyframes. Copy the right leg's rotation keyframes and paste them onto the left leg. Then offset the left leg's rotation keyframes so that they don't move at the same time as the right leg. Change the left leg's keyframes values to randomize the animation speed of both legs. To animate the head, we'll copy the left leg's rotation keyframes and paste them onto the head group. Duplicate these keyframes. Then select repeat after last keyframe to loop the head animation. Offset the head for about 8 frames because when the Superman is flying forward, his head will be leading the motion, so it has to move before other body parts. We'll copy these head's keyframes and paste them onto the left arm and offset them. Then copy the left arm's keyframes to the right arm, and repeat the process of looping it. But we'll offset the right arm's keyframes by moving them forward in the timeline, to make the right arm move after the head and left arm. We also need to make the right arm's shadow move with it as well. When the Superman flies, his hair will be affected by the wind. We'll keyframe the hair's Z rotation to create this motion. For the eyes and eyebrows, we'll keyframe their Y position to create a subtle up and down motion. When the Superman goes up, his belly becomes smaller, and it gets bigger when he goes down. We'll keyframe the body's X and Y scale to achieve this motion. Do the same to the belly's shading and the logo on his suit. Lastly, we'll add some horizontal speed lines to give the illusion that the character is flying at a fast speed. We'll start with one line first by keyframing its first and last point offset. Then copy the first line's keyframes to other lines. Make a few copies of the burst lines group, and offset them to create continuous speed lines. Make sure the speed lines look the same at the starting point and ending point of your timeline, to create perfect looping speed lines. And we have just created a flying Superman with Motion 5 without using any third-party plugin. The project files of this tutorial are available to download on our website. For more information about our Motion 5 project files, please check the link in the description section below. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next tutorial.